As you see, the home side in the green and white vertical hoops are ready to get things going. Swansea, well, they're green and black, and they have the away kit on. And you'll see a lot of water on the pitch. You'll see that shining up there as the players move. You'll see it just splashing up. The pitch was well watered just before the kickoff, and that's sure to get the ball moving around quickly on this warm night. So Matty Grimes in the centre, one who's gone out there and put other clubs' games under his belt in order to give himself the experience to now dominate in the heart of the Swans midfield, winning all those trophies at the end of season awards last season. Ball forward, McBurney, as he usually does, holding players off, early ball through, Selina. Now then, first chance for Swansea, and Selina gets the first goal of the night inside 4 minutes. Terrific start. It stuck a little in the water, but he had the control to get it out in front of him and slip it past the advancing Stuart Nelson in the Yeovil goal. And they're stroking it round nicely, moving forward Swansea at the moment. Routledge, plenty of support for him just behind. Swansea working it through the middle, and Fulton hitting an absolute beauty, right-footed, 25 yards the distance, and he's lifted it over the keeper. That is a quality strike.
That's a great strike from Jay Fulton. He knew exactly what he was doing, and he knew exactly where he wanted to put that ball, and a great curling away from the keeper into the far corner. He'd be pleased with that one, and so will his manager.
Chance for Dyer to stretch his legs again over on that right hand side, and it's a through ball to get McBurney running now. Goes wide on the left, looks up, who's with him in the centre? Does he need anyone? It's Ollie McBurney to shoot. Keeper makes the save, and it's toe poked out of the 18 yard box and away. Well, gets it back from McBurney, and Bidwell makes a run down the left hand side, links up with Selina. And he'll fancy a shot himself, and it's inside the post and back out. Lovely touch by McBurney. Bursts forward, looks up, plays it through. Selina lifts it, or tries to lift it over the keeper, left-footed. So far tonight, we've got Person Selina and Jay Fulton. And there's a goal back for the home side. Once again, it's a set piece as the ball comes in from the right-hand side. And Tom Bradbury, the man to connect.
Steve Cooper would be really disappointed with that goal. A little bit earlier, they defended their first set piece, the corner, really well. Ollie McBurney clearing his lines. But that, from that free kick, Bradbury was allowed to run free.
Selina gets it back. Wide, space, time, looks up. Man in front of him, goes past that man, still has the ball into the centre. Space for Bidwell, drills it, and his shot is deflected away for a corner kick.
One to give away too many free kicks. If you look through the Yeovil team, they're quite a big side. People like Bradbury, Collins, Dickinson, Skendi.
Quick turn, a quick release by Routledge. McBurney plays it back in, and Selina tries to stab it towards the goal. It's just over. The home captain cleared away. The break is short-lived for the Glovers' defence. Bidwell. Roberts. Selina steps over as that challenge flies in, and Swansea get another corner. Grimes hits it high into the centre. McBurney's up. Keeper makes the save. It's in at the second attempt. And Swansea City are leading by 3-1. And Jay Fulton is the one that gets the close range touch.
Great delivery then from Matty Grimes, one of those keeper just a little bit too far out for him to come and get. McBurney alive to the situation. Good header, good save from Nelson. But Fulton was alive and got his second of the game.
Two 11s in there. Certainly seems difficult. Dire space. Is there a forthcoming? The step over for Salina. Oh, and the shot is saved by Nelson when really you would have put money on him. Salina going to wrap that right foot around it now. Low into the box and against the underside of the crossbar, and it is a hat-trick for Jay Fulton.
Great move by Swansea. Salina just pulling the ball back again. That's something they've obviously worked on the training ground. And a great strike from Jay Fulton to complete his hat-trick. He'll be delighted at that. Yeovil perhaps getting a little bit frustrated.
I think it could be a long night for Dickinson if Osoro is happy to continue running at him. And there is Osoro, edge of the box, forced wide, gets a low shot, it bounces round, and that should... Oh, I was going to say it should be. Unable to jump and win the ball back for Swansea. A couple of changes for the home side over on the far side of the field. I wouldn't be surprised if Carl Dickinson is about to come off. McBurney cuts inside onto the left foot. McBurney blasts it, and the keeper makes a good, strong one-handed. If the pattern of play continues with different personnel, Mackay into Danda, certainly looking good so far, as Baker Richardson lays it off the Byers, who will hit one low foot with the right foot.
Reseed it, so it's ready for the new campaign.
Mackay breaking through for Swansea City. The Swans number 7 scores Swansea's number 5.
Good finish from Mackay, kept his composure. Scored the equaliser out in Spain, and they crossed the border into Portugal to play Mansfield. Scored a very, very late equaliser.
Fires his back heel. Osoro skips over the challenge. Space over to the left, and the ball is taken over to that side of the field by Jan Dander. A determined run with a cross, and that was Baker Richardson's finish. Yeovil still buoyant from their conference days. The Dander produces a fine save from Nelson. Byers turns space. Does he fancy a shot? He does. Nelson saves, and there's a chance. And Courtney Baker Richardson makes it Yeovil 1, Swansea 6 in injury time.
Great work from Byers as well, cutting in from the left into the area. Good right-footed shot. Nelson will perhaps be a little bit disappointed not to hold on to that or push it away from the danger zone, but Baker Richardson perfectly placed.
Here again with space on that right-hand side. Swansea City on the attack. Dander right to the byline. And Nelson getting his hands around that one. And certainly, I think they had to take Carl Dickinson off in that left-back role, but since he's gone, Swansea have had even more joy on that particular side of the field.
I think both wingers have done well this second half. Osoro on the right, Barry Mackay on the left as well, and that's the final whistle.
So a convincing victory scoreline-wise for Swansea City, and indeed in the way that they played this evening. Steve Cooper's going to be delighted with that evening's work, Jonathan Wilson.
He definitely will, yeah. First half was excellent. They started off the second half as well, the way they left the first. Apart from the odd 5-10 minute spell in that second half, Swansea well on top as the game progressed.